basically what how you break in your new baseball glove is really just, you know, putting your hand in it, playing catch, just getting out there and playing some plain old catch. I mean, you can use conditioner and steaming it, but I don't really want to do that. I just really want to just play catch with it, you know, break it in that way. It's really good to do that way. Another way you can do it is you take your knee and you take the glove and you push on the net or pocket. You push down like that with your knee and then you turn the glove inside outward. And then that makes the glove more flexible, which makes the glove turn inside outward. But that makes the glove more flexible doing that. Then you just take your knee, or you can just do it this way, but you take your knee and you just pop it back into place. Make sure your neck's all nice and good. I mean, I'll do that to begin with, but it'll make it more loose. And then you just sort of do this. Sort of bend it back and forth. Don't do that too much with the neck, because the neck is starting to do that when you make that too floppy. And then make it, really hard to catch there, because it'll just fall right out. So you really don't want to do that. You start to breathe the fingers back and forth. Mine's, getting there, getting broken in. So yeah, that's how you break in your glove. And that's really my way of breaking it in. You can condition it, steam it, and put it in your oven, but I really wouldn't recommend putting it in your oven, because these little tassels here and stuff, like all over your glove, if it's like a glove that has like tassels on it, like they're fake leather also. Some gloves are real leather, however this glove isn't real leather, it's a cheaper glove. But anyway, you put it in your oven, they'll dry up, you get real brittle, and break off. So don't put it in your oven, even if you use that shampoo stuff, still don't put it in your oven. And a lot of people like to pull their gloves' fingers like this to flare it. I really don't like that, because the way it makes it look like all curvy and sloppy. I just don't like the way that looks. There's plenty of good old catch with it, going like this. Some people have baseball mallets. I think there's videos up on YouTube on how to make the mallet. But, you know, just doing that with your hand, doing it with a baseball, playing catch, doing what I just showed you, moving your fingers back and forth. It just makes it, you don't want it too floppy. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. And, there are going to be 3 videos posted. Will these be one of them? Then the other one is a glove review. And the next one, you'll just have to wait and see what it is. It's sort of a surprise. I'll be doing a review on something. Let's just put it that way. Okay? Alright, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Catch you guys next time on the channel.